Okay friends, now in this video we will discuss about that what are the main points and what are the main topics that you should focus upon while revising the current affairs or while doing the current affairs. So we will go with subject wise. First subject is science and tech. So how to go and what are the main topics in the science and tech that you should focus upon. So friends, first thing is in science and tech, focus upon the defense sector. So what are the main requirements of the defense sector? Like there we have the requirement of around 40 squadrons in the IAF, 40 or 2 in the Indian Air Force squadrons are there. But what are our capacity, and each squadron has 16 aircrafts and some things like that. And then Rafale has been in news, so what are the main specifications? Then Tejas, Indian made aircraft, and so you should have some knowledge about these things. So from defense sector is important. Then space is also very important. There has been various news regarding the space sector in recent times. Then focus on the new technology sector. Like new technologies have been coming in recent times. Blockchain is there, artificial intelligence is there, Internet of Things is there, then quantum technology is there. So the a new word has come, that quantum supremacy. What is this quantum supremacy? What is quantum supremacy? So even Google and IBM has also claimed that they have made the quantum computer. So what are the main applications of quantum computers? And so these are the main priority things that you should focus upon from science and tech. There has not been a trend that many questions from the science and tech are not asked from the NCERTs or something like that. But in these last days, you can skip the NCERT portion and focus on these current affairs from the science and tech. There is much possibility that questions will be asked from these sectors from science and tech portion. Second is environment, and environment you have to focus upon various bodies in the environment, and who is the chairman of those bodies and what are the main function of those bodies. Their regulations are there with various acts in the environments, like this regarding Wildlife Protection Act, Environment Protection Act. Then there are various rules like solid waste management rules and CRZ regulations are also there. So you have to focus on these things. Then there are some new species which have been declared critically endangered or have been added to the vulnerable or endangered species list of these species. So you should focus on those things. Then the other thing with environment is that there has been various questions from the agriculture sectors also from there. So and why it is happening is that because the Indian Forest Service examination, prelims examination is also clubbed with the Civil Services Prelims Examination. So there are various questions from the environment, and some specific questions are being asked from agriculture and from forestry and all these things. So friends, you have to focus more on the environment. There would be specific question. If you do not know the answer, then I would recommend that you skip it. Otherwise it may go wrong and it may hurt you. Third is the polity section. In the polity section you have to focus on ministries. There are various schemes and acts. So which scheme is being implemented by which ministry? What are the various objectives of that scheme? And what are the various targets of that scheme? For example, for Make in India, the target is that to increase the contribution of manufacturing sector to 20 to 25%. So you have to focus on these things. Then for geography, you have to focus on locations. Atlas is very important because every year they are asking questions from the atlas. One or two questions will be there from atlas. So for Indian locations, you have to also focus upon the longitude and latitudes and what are the main locations. See it in the atlas actually, and what are the other locations that are also coming in consonance with these locations. And for locations from the world map is Middle East. You have to focus on Middle East, from Central Asia, Southeast Asia, South Asia. South China Sea is also very important. Various straits in the oceans are also very important. So focus on those things from geography. Then also there has been various changes in the new national parks have been added. Then new sites in the Ramsar sites has been added recently. And so you should also focus on these things. from international point of view, there has been various reports by various international institutions like World Bank, IMF is there. So how to approach these things? First thing is which report is being published by which institution, first thing. Then what is the India's position? Rank is important, but much important thing is that what's India's position as comparable to the other countries, vis-a-vis other countries, like India's position with respect to BRICS countries, like if India is at the bottom or India is at the top. Similarly, India's position with respect to Southeast Asian countries or South Asian countries. So you have a look at these things from this perspective. Then other thing is from economics point of view. You have to focus upon the reports by SEBI, by various institutions like SEBI, RBI, Ministry of Finance. Then these institutions are being controlled. Various bodies are there which are being controlled and monitored by RBI or SEBI. You have to focus on these things. Then also slightly more focus on the steps that has been taken by RBI in recent times, like the Yes Bank crisis was there, so there has been a moratorium on the Yes Bank, so the RBI can put moratoriums on under which act. Similarly, RBI put moratorium on every type of bank, or some bodies are still out of the purview of RBI. You have to focus on those things. Then also I would also suggest that take a look on the terms and the words which have been mentioned in the economic survey and the budget, like taxpayer charter has been added in this year budget in the Income Tax Act. So what is taxpayer charter? So is it the first that in the world that India has been doing, or has it been implemented in some other country also? So these things are also very important. Then also focus upon composition of various bodies and their chairman, their appointment, who is doing the appointment, like Monetary Policy Committee is there. Like last year there was question that who would be selecting the chairman of the banks. So you have to focus on those things. And for history, mainly the questions from history is from the static portion, but still current affairs is slightly relevant in the history portion. How it is important that you have to look out for the places of excavation. There has been various excavation in recent times, so there may be question not directly from those, but some related with those things. Like there has been excavation in Rakhigadi, and it has also been mentioned by the Honorable Finance Minister in the budget speech. So you should focus what is the significance of the Rakhigadi in our ancient history. Similarly, there are some events in the history which have completed their 100 years, or their 50 years, 75 years, 200 years have been completed. Like this is 2020. So the events which have been there in 1920, like non-cooperation movement, Khilafat movement, and other things. Corona has come in 2020, so Spanish flu was there in 1920. So you have to focus on those things. There may be questions from these things. So these are the things that you have to focus while doing the current affairs subject wise. I would have I would also like to say that this is not an exhaustive list. So whatever you have done and whatever you are doing from various sources, continue doing it. The main takeaway point from this video is that first revise daily you can do your current affairs portion. Do not leave it for the last 10 days or last 5 or 10, 7 days. It will not help you. Revision is the key for the current affairs. You have to minimize your confusion for various things. So remember the factual things. If you are not able to remember them, then make some notes, very small notes, make some on the sticky notes, paste it on the wall and have a look at every 1 hour or 2 hour, or whenever you are relaxing, take a look at those important things or those factual things, those targets, those reports, and those ministries, those schemes under which ministry it is working. So these type of things you have to focus upon for the current affairs. And I hope that you would be doing very great. And do not panic in these times. Even whatever you have done is sufficient. The only thing in the exam required in the exam is that you attempt the paper with calm and composed mind. That is very important, because only then you would be able to do the questions. Even if you do not know the answer, then you would be making an intelligent guess, and for that you need a very very peaceful mind. So I would advise that you remain in a state of peaceful, so you can try some meditation or yoga for that. And so friends, I hope that you will clear the exam with flying colors, and all the best to you. So thank you very much.